First of all, before we start, let's just introduce ourselves. And we'll start with...
Mike.
Mike?
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Ray Hesson. I'm the lead singer, bass player, and keyboardist for Lost Calls. I'm from right here in Bowie, Maryland.
Okay.
It's Tim. I'm lead guitarist. Mike plays a lot of lead, but usually lead man.
My name is Ben Hesson. I'm the stick man. I play the drums.
Okay, I just want to say that these three are brothers. We've known them for quite some time. In fact, I knew them before they were born. So we're excited about it tonight too. Just kind of tell me, how did you find out about this contest, and how many were involved in it? Because this is the last night, and what goes on from there? Who wants to be a spokesman?
Bowie's been sponsoring Battle of the Bands for years, and for years we've been coming here and listening to them. And by the time we got our band started, we thought, hey, why don't we try it? So. And here we are. That's basically it.
It's just a milestone.
Okay. And what is there anything that goes on if you win the final? Or
if we win, roughly $500.
At least.
Uh-huh.
If we lose,
$300.
Oh, okay.
So, and there's something in it.
And another thing is you get a lot of publicity, like on DC 101. You know, that's one big thing.
Right.
Okay. So there is an incentive then for you to
win. Yeah.
Could you tell me how you got your name, and is there a story behind it?
When we were first playing, we thought we weren't too good, and we didn't even have a name, so later we just said, we're a lost cause, and then it hit us.
We picked it up.
We got a lost cause.
Hit him.
To meet the father of the Hesson brothers, this is Ray Hesson.
Hi.
We were just talking to the guys, and they said they were a little nervous. Are you nervous for them?
Only because there's not very many people here yet.
You said that's what they were nervous about.
Yeah, they're ready. I mean, I heard them practicing last night. They really sounded good, so I know they're ready. And I think they're a little nervous about the fact they have to go on first. And they're nervous because there aren't a lot of people. And that makes a difference with the acoustics, too. But they get pumped up more, you know,
right.
There's a big
so
crowd.
So what do you think about all this? They said it's only been about a year and a month or so that they've seriously been doing this. What do you think about it as a parent and as a musician yourself?
Well, as Yogi Berra said, it's like deja vu all over again, you know, because it seemed like only a few years ago that my ex-wife's band was practicing in the living room, and now they are. The neighbors would probably be just as happy if we'd move.
How do you feel?
Nervous. We're very nervous. At least I am.
I was nervous the last time we played, but I know what to expect now. And
a lot of songs we haven't played for a while, and we had add some more. I'm not sure about
I'm
the lyrics.
Cool.
Yeah,
you're cool.
We're the drummer, of course. He's always.
We made up a song in the past 2 weeks since we play. I mean, we didn't even know. We just made it up in the past 2 weeks, and so I'm hoping that turns out all right. I don't know. We're kind of shaky
on it. How many songs do you have to play?
About 20.
About 18.
That's how. And how many sets?
Two sets. 45 and 30-minute set.
Well, let's go in and see what's going in on there.
Yeah, they'll be ready.
We want bodies for them, right?
14 minutes, right? They're on.
Okay. Thanks, Ray.
Right.
Applause from Bowie, Maryland, Lost Cause.
They used to always fight, I guess like all brothers, they'd fight like the Dickens, and it wasn't until they began playing music together that they even seemed to like each other a little bit. I'm still not sure they like each other, but they seem to depend on each other more. And it's been a very, very positive thing for them, and it's been a very enjoyable thing for me to watch as a parent. It's kind of a neat feeling to see your own children get together in a very, very useful activity, very creative activity like music, and see them be successful. And not only successful, but to be able to establish a kind of a peer envy, you might say. You know, some kids are able to do this, I guess, most commonly in athletics. Going out and winning football games and baseball games. It's kind of neat to see the kids able to achieve some measure of success and status among their friends doing something different like this. kids, and they used to go to the Battle of the Bands when they were 13, 14 years old. Boy, did they envy these kids so much, the ones that were in the band. They used to think that was a especially high standard for musicians, and they were so excited when they first got accepted just to be in the battle, and then of course they won the first round. I suppose it's natural to get caught up in that sort of thing, much like a parent who wants to see their kids on the football team win or the baseball team or what have you. So it was very exciting for me to, and I, if I looked calm, it was a good act, because I was not calm at all. I was, in fact, if I remember correctly, I think I was jumping around more than anybody else, except maybe for Ben.
About Lost Cause, we're not an ordinary garage band. You go around, and I guess the trend now is either this rap, it can fall in three categories, either rap, super thrash, heavy metal, or this postmodern. Everyone wants to be, I want to be like The Cure, or I want to be like Metallica, or I want to be like Belle Biv DeVoe, you know, but we never think like that. We just think, hey, look, this sounds good, let's try this out. You know, we're very, very open-minded. You know, we don't try to think like, hey, I want to sound like this, or I want this Eddie Van Halen guitar sound. No, uh-uh. So, I mean, we're Lost Cause, you know.
Well, working with three brothers, it's definitely extremely pressured because they all have their ways of doing things, and of course, they're of the same blood, so they're gonna act not always the same, but they have their own idea. When I look in the mirror, what do I see? Pictures of you printed inside of me. I can't go on another day now. A star when everybody else is a star, I don't know, I guess I'd talk about the same old things. I'm kind of a simple guy, have my car, have my woman, have my house, and I guess I'd be a happy man from then on. But yeah, I love guitar, I want to stick into it, but there's college sitting aside, and that's my conflict right now, whether I should go into college or stay here and work out with the band. We'll be right back.
One thing I don't ever really want to do, unless I'm really pressed for money, is play every night at a bar or something for, you know, $50 a night, because, you know, you really don't get anywhere with that. You know, I like to take a risk. You know, I'd like to, you know, put a lot of effort and really hope for a big thing rather than putting a little bit of effort and getting just very minimum out of it. So, I'm ambitious. I am like a fifth member of the band, and I feel like the band's gonna go a long way and try to promote it as best as I can. Like, talk at work about it, promote the album, sales and everything's great, but I just, you know, run the sound, I do a little video here and there and make tapes and just a little member of the band.
I grew up in a musical family. My mom sang in a band called Fringe, and they made it pretty big. They toured a little bit in the area, in Maryland and Virginia and Delaware and all the surrounding states. And my dad's in a bluegrass band named Foggy Bottom, and they made it pretty big. They've been together for the past almost 20 years now. And I just grew up around music. My mom showed me some songs on the piano. I almost dropped the piano. I never play the piano anymore. I should, but, you know, I've got more into guitar in the past couple years. But I've just grown up in a completely musical family, and that's how I got to where I am today.
basically Battle of the Bands came around just, you know, a couple months after we started practicing all together. We made a little demo tape, sent it in, and we're surprised that we even got in the Battle of the Bands. You know, we got really psyched up for the Battle of the Bands. We practiced a lot. You know, we were ready. You know, we were just basically happy to get in. And we were the third band to play, and we heard both other bands before we started, and that gave us a lot more confidence, because, you know, we thought we had a chance. Then once we played, the crowd just was totally on our side. I think we won over the crowd, and more so gave us more confidence. So we ended up winning the first week, and we went into the finals having a lot of confidence, and basically easily won, you know. And when I look back, I used to think the bands that won the Battle of the Bands, you know, I used to want their autographs. I even did give an autograph, as a matter of fact.
All right, are you ready to hear for the winner of the 8th annual Bowie Battle of the Bands?
Yes!
The winner, ladies and gentlemen, is Lost Cause.